Good morning and welcome to part two of our family to family Christmas service. Now, I know that a lot of us have been impacted by all that this year has brought, right? But just like the angel in Luke chapter 2 came to the shepherds to reassure them that he was bringing good news. He even described it as the most joyous news the world has ever heard. Well, I too, like that angel, I have good news. Isn't it wonderful that we can all gather together virtually to share in the love, the joy, and the beauty that this season offers? So come, go with me. I cannot wait for you all to see what we're about to do. We are about to unwrap some beautiful giftings and talents that Born Again Church has so graciously been blessed with. And most importantly, we are about to unwrap the greatest, most precious gift of them all, the best gift, that is the gift of Jesus Christ. And so may all of who he is and all that he has be yours eternally. Merry Christmas from our family to yours.
Of the year. It's a time of celebration and being thankful and grateful, and we're so blessed for the gift that God has given us. So, would you love to get a present wrapped up in a Christmas bow? God gave each of us a present on that night so long ago. It's a gift that keeps on giving if our spirits can receive. It's the secret joy of giving if our hearts can just believe. And the gift goes on.
It's just the time to continue to give thanks. It's a refreshing of our spirits, appreciating the little things in life, thinking positively, and identifying the goodness that comes your way, treasuring each moment and each other, uniting in kindness, delighting in laughter, and just expressing the joy of the season. Sister Hawken and I would just like to say,
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. From our house to yours.
God bless.
Welcome to our Christmas celebration. I'm your host, Denver. Let's check out my classmate.
I want some new toys called that drive by itself with the remote control.
I know. A Hawaiian ninja set, even a Lego set. That's what I'm in Barbie dolls. I like LOLs too. That's what I want for Christmas.
Elephant Mama. A Jurassic World Evolutions game.
A basketball goal. And a basketball.
Nothing really.
You don't want anything for Christmas?
No.
I want a rocket skateboard.
What I would like for Christmas is a real unicorn. Just a baby unicorn.
Presents?
There's a lot of things I want. I want a Nintendo Switch, and I want a Rainbow High Salon doll.
A Nintendo Switch that I can connect to my Xbox, and I can play games on it.
Jewelry and toy?
I do not know yet. I don't know yet.
A transformer car? That's all I want.
Sticky slime.
Wow.
Sticky slime.
A Nintendo Switch, Xbox, PS4, hoverboard, and a TV.
A computer.
I want Santa Claus and Snowman.
That's all?
Yeah. Who's that? That man.
Yeah.
Whoops. A New American Girl doll.
I want is a car, and I want a Barbie car, and I want some the Barbie doll food. And I even want.
Some new shoes.
She's probably going some perfume.
I don't know. Maybe more makeup or nails.
She wants something like flowers.
I had to think about that.
She wants money. All she wants is money and cash.
A new car.
She don't need nothing for Christmas.
Maybe a dog, a real dog.
Christmas tree.
I think she wants a new phone.
Yeah, a dog portal.
A coffee cup.
She said, I don't know.
I don't know, but I'm gonna give him a wallet.
He want work. He doesn't want anything for Christmas.
I don't know.
A condom.
Some slippers. He's gonna get a gun, like a fake toy gun.
He wants the, like, you know where you shoot hoops, basketball? He wants a basketball hoop in the driveway so he can play with Jeremiah.
He wants a barber shop, a new gun.
He never told me.
New shoes or something. I love you.
I love you and I'm ready to go to heaven.
I would offer him some cookies.
Happy birthday, Jesus. Happy birthday, Jesus. And I still have to work on the ending.
One of the people died and it's my pupo. But that's okay, because the Lord will protect him. That's all right.
Merry Christmas. Guys, I have missed you so much. Being a part of children's ministry, youth ministry, young adult, it's been a joy. But in this particular season, where I don't get to see you, I don't get to touch you, I can't really talk to you person to person, it is, man, it's hard, it's been incredible. But I know during this season, I just pray that you enjoyed it. I enjoyed the time off being a part of, in-home school. So I really hope that that's been a blessing to you. But I just wanted to come today to let you know you are so missed. Miss you in children's church with the lessons and just running around playing the games. And of course, I know you miss the treasure chest because I miss the treasure chest. But just hope that you're doing great and hope you're enjoying this holiday season. And just wanted you to know, just take this time out to just, you know, love on your family, you know, hug them a little bit longer, squeeze them a little bit tighter, and just enjoy this time because it's an unusual season. But Jeremiah tells us God already knew the plan that he had for you. He wanted to prosper you in every way, not to harm you. He knew you had there was a hope and a future, and it's still a hope and a future because he's still on the throne and he's still doing great things. So in this season of, you know, just getting a gift, give a gift too. Even if it's just your time, even if it's just, you know, to sit down and go old school with the Christmas story, but enjoy it and be just glad and thankful and safe. Because I know, you know, masks are not fashionable, but at the same time, they're needed. So put them on so that you can be safe. And not only that, your loved ones can be safe as well. I wanted to take this time out just to pray a covering of protection, and then to pray an encouraging blessing over you, because I'm encouraged because of what you've been doing. For my youth department, you have done such amazing things just staying connected and being a part of all the digital stuff that's going on, and you're engaged. Our young adults, I honor what you've been doing. It is a tremendous blessing. You have been the soldiers, kind of on the field in a digital sense, to keeping everything connected. I love the testimonies of the groups and everything that has happened, that you've just blossomed, and you stood in a gap that we didn't know was going to be a gap. But it just reminds me, when you hear the scripture says you are more than a conqueror, it's true. We think of wars and battles and things of that nature, but I think of times like this, that to be more than. You are more than a conqueror, because the circumstances, situations, everything that's happened to us, you have engaged and you have consistently reached out, spreading the gospel, training another generation, and you've been connected. And that is to be honored and cherished. So I love you, I miss you, and I just want you to know that everything's gonna be okay. There is hope, and guess what? We're it. We are the light of the world. You know, we don't know how high the hill is gonna be, but when God sets us on that hill, we have to shine, and we have to shine bright. So be encouraged, and I wanna pray for you. So Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you with these human words that you have given us. Thank you doesn't seem like it's enough, but we say thank you. It's a time to be grateful. It's a time to be thankful wholeheartedly. We thank you for everything that you've done. We thank you for the place in which you have brought us. We thank you for making yourself known to us. We thank you for letting all the blessings to come and to overtake us. We thank you for the sorrow being departed from us. We just thank you, Lord God, because our loved ones that are safe, even those that have transitioned home, God, you still, that was in your plan. They're in a much, much better place. And yet we miss them. At the same time, we are encouraged because we will see them again. So Father, our children that are out there, and whether they're, you know, in school or in homeschool, I pray this covering of blessing, covering of protection, Lord, a covering of love, just to surround them in such a way that they know that they can physically, tangibly feel your arms being wrapped around them. In this season where we have to practice this social distancing, Father, you are never distant from us. You are forever present. You said you would never leave us, nor would you forsake us, and you're always here. I thank you, Lord God, for our young people that have stepped up to the plate, and they have done some great things. And yet, blessings to come upon them like raindrops, giving them the strength, the creativity even more, the strategies, all of those things to spread your gospel in such a way that the world sees it, and the world acknowledges it, and the world embraces it. We are the salt of the earth, and you've called us to be that light on the hill. What a better time to be that light in what the world seems darkness. So we know without a doubt you're still in control, Father, and you still are on the throne watching over us and seeing to it that your plan is being completed in our lives. And we are so grateful and so thankful. So in this season of celebrating your son coming into this earth and doing all of what he had to do for us, we say thank you. Thank you for going out and covering each and every one of us, covering our homes, our families, covering this time, giving those food who are hungry, clothes for the naked, and Father, for reminding us of who you are and where you've been this entire time, because you've always been right here with us. So we thank you, dear Lord, in Jesus' mighty name, amen. Thank you, family. I say it again, I miss you, and I can't wait to be able to see you, laugh, hug, and of course, eat with you too. Enjoy your holiday season, and know that God loves you, and we do too. Thank you.
for one like me. And in this very room, there's quite enough joy for one like me. And there's quite enough hope and quite enough power to chase away any gloom. For Jesus, Lord Jesus.
Good morning, Born Again family. You know, I love that song. In this very room, there's quite enough love for all of us. And I'm glad you're here in this room with me today. You know, on last Sunday, I talked about great expectations for the gifts that I hope to receive on Christmas morning. To be perfectly honest, as a child, I don't remember ever having a disappointing Christmas. Of course, when I was young, I thought Santa Claus was the one who was blessing us with all those toys. But as we got older, we knew it was Mom and Dad who were doing what they needed to do to be a blessing to their children. My earliest memory of Christmas, praise God, I think Elder Harold and I received a Lionel locomotive. This was a toy train set. We were so excited when we saw it, but I don't remember it actually working. I think my father and my Uncle John, who were putting it together, played with it so much on Christmas Eve that by the time we got to it on Christmas morning, it ceased to function. But you put some kind of little powder in the chimney on the locomotive, and you put a match to it, and then it would smoke. And as the train went around the track, it's supposed to be like a little steam engine. But that toy, praise God, just the idea of it brought us great joy. Then when I got a little older, and this was probably around 1958, a new TV show had started, and it was called Have Gun Will Travel, starring Richard Boone, and his name was Paladin. And he dressed in all black, and so all of the kids in the neighborhood were just enthusiastic about watching this new Western. And so that's what I wanted for Christmas. I wanted the gun that Paladin wore. And you've heard me talk about this before. This gun was actually, the holster of the gun was actually on a pivot. So he didn't have to pull the gun out of the holster to shoot. All he would do is just pivot the holster and he could shoot. I got that gun for Christmas, and I have you to know that instantaneously I was the fastest shot in our neighborhood. Then when we got a little older, this is probably the most memorable, and I guess you could say functional gift that we received, and my brother and I got bicycles. And this bicycle brought us to the place where our boundaries that had been so set, we were now able to, you know, kind of expand those boundaries. And you could get on that bike, and you could travel further than Mom had allowed you to go, and you could get back quicker, praise God, than if you were actually walking. And whether this bike meant so much to me, and I had to be about maybe 12 years old when I got it, but I rode that bike until I was a senior in high school. I was talking with Elder Harold the other night, and he asked me, whatever happened to them? And we don't remember, but I do remember when we moved away, we got a car. Now, before we moved, we got a car, and so the bikes probably didn't mean that much to us anymore. So then I brought something with me today because I wanted you to see this. This is not a toy that was given me, but this is a toy that I gave a kid and I gave Chip when he was about 2 years old. We would take early morning walks around our apartment complex. Brian would be in a stroller, and Chip wanted to wear his tool belt. And this drill was a part of that tool belt. So this particular toy is about 42 years old, and you see it still functions. I don't know what happened to the other parts that stick into the screwdrivers and things that you would put in it, but it still works. Then this particular toy is actually older than that one. This is probably was Chip's best friend when he was a baby. And this is how I used to entertain my baby son. So this particular toy is about 44 years old. Hey, how are you today? You doing good? Do you recognize that guy behind the camera? Is he your best friend? Come on, give him a big hug. So I would take stuffed animals, all those stuffed animals had a personality, and introduce them to our kids, and they would talk to them and act like they were listening and things of that nature. But Chip really enjoyed this as a child. Then on last Sunday, I told you that I had a gift that I wanted to open for you. And this is what I brought today. Because some gifts, and you can imagine that every time I look at this drill, the joy that it brings to my spirit, every time I pick up that little puppet or see it again, the joy that it brings to my spirit. Some gifts are perpetual. They continue to give. And that's the type of gift that we've received by receiving Jesus Christ as our Lord and personal Savior. He gives and he gives and he gives. But then I realized that he gives in other ways as well. And so when I promised you that I was going to open the gift, praise God, and this gift has been given to me, and I need you to see what's on the inside, because this is a perpetual gift. It's been a gift given to me, to my family, to my wife, and to this ministry. And I just want you to look and see what's on the inside. The perpetual gift is you. You have been there with us over this 42-year period. You listened to a little skinny boy who had a dream, a vision, and you bought into that vision. And some of you came on a little earlier than others, but you have worked. You have lended your gifts, your talents, your resources, your finances. And we are today where we are today because you have given to the Lord's work perpetually. And I want to thank you for that.
I look at what we've experienced over this year in 2020, the pandemic and all of the things that have touched us, the levels of turmoil and grief that as a body and just as a nation and as a world that we've had to endure. But even in the midst of a pandemic, you got boots on the ground, you were still functioning and working in a way that was bringing liberty and life to so many people. And I want you to know that we need you and we thank God for you. And because of you, Born Again Church is what it is today. And you are that gift that continues to give. We have much more to accomplish. We got a fair ways to go. And we want to go that distance with you on our side. So don't let anyone ever tell you that you're not gifted. You are gifted. You are the gift that keeps on giving. Merry Christmas, Born Again. We love you.
In this season where the family has been somewhat under attack from the coronavirus to financial difficulties to just various stresses with children going to college and children in school, we need grace. We need the love and grace of the Father to bless us. So I just want to pray briefly for you as the Holy Spirit put this prayer on my heart. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for each unit and member of the family. We thank you for those husbands who have been called to nurture their wives and to lay their lives down as Christ did for the church. We pray your blessings on these men that head their homes. We pray for those that are caregivers, to an ailing parent, to those, Lord, who have teenagers that they are covering, young adults that they are still ministering to, even grandchildren that they're pouring into. We pray for those precious wives, Father, those wives that come alongside their husbands and are those helpmeets, those women, Lord, that you've graced to be in our body to help their husbands to become the men that you created them to be. Bless them, increase them, make your face shine upon them and give them great peace. Lord, we pray for the singles, whether they are singles in their teens or in their 20s, or even singles that may even be widows now. We cover them. We pray your blessings upon them that during this season that they would understand the grace and the mercy that you have for them, and that they will take their singlehood and just love on you and minister to you and let that overflow. Lord, we pray for those that may be even hurting, Lord, in their families, whether they're going through some type of trial or test, whether it's even at the point of divorce. We pray healing, oh God. You're the God that heals us and makes us whole. You're the one that gives us hope. Lord, even the song that has been playing in this very room, there is quite enough love for all of us. You are love, but you desire that love to flow from our hearts and our bosom to one another. And that's what we are doing as we pray this prayer. We're asking that you would envelop every person, whether they are members of Born Again, whether they are visitors who are watching, that their love would just be outpoured on them right now, that they would feel the touch that they need to carry on. And Lord God, we weep with those who weep, those that have lost loved ones and that are grieving during this holiday season. Lord, we weep with them. And then we rejoice with those that rejoice, those that are celebrating some level of victory, something that you did wonderful. And they are just praising you, oh God, with all their heart, mind, and strength. They are coming up from the depths of their being with gratitude and thanksgiving. And Lord, we also pray in the name of Jesus for our church body as a whole, that we will continue, Lord God, to unite and become one, that we will continue, Lord God, to stand and be the witness and examples that you poured out your grace upon us to be holy, Lord, to be humble, to be pure, to be ambassadors for you, Lord God, to touch and to reach out and touch others. And Lord, finally, in the name of Jesus, we just pray that we will all understand that we are gifts. First of all, gifts to you, and then gifts to one another. And that we would understand who you are as a gift to us. And that we will receive all that you have for us. Lord, you're taking us into a whole new year. We've come through 2020. We've seen a lot. We've seen things that we've never seen before. We've heard things that we've never heard before. and our hearts have been overwhelmed. But your word says, when our hearts are overwhelmed, run to the rock that is higher than us, and we run to you. Day in and day out, we keep on knocking. We keep on seeking. We keep on, Lord God, coming before you, your throne. Yeah, we came yesterday. Yes, we prayed yesterday, but we're going to keep praying. We're going to keep knocking. We're going to keep seeking. But most of all, we're going to keep believing and receiving all that you have for us. We pray this in the mighty name of Jesus. And by the way, we take authority over every spirit that's not the Holy Spirit. We bind every demonic force that's trying to harass, torment, vex, oppress, depress, repress, or whatever he's trying to do. We scatter him right now. He has no dominion over the people of God. We pray that the authority of the believer would rise up by the power of the Holy Spirit and break free of every shackle, break free of every burden, break free of every care, and receive all that you have for us. Holy Spirit, we continue to welcome you each and every day and each and every moment into our lives. And Father, to you be all the praise, all the glory and the honor, both now and forever. In Jesus' name, amen.
Over 20 years ago, God gave me a special friend. We had such a great relationship. We were like Jonathan and David. Nothing could separate us from one another. Years would pass, 20 years almost would pass, and we were still so, so close. But then something happened. I had a big life transition. Things were going on in her life. And all of a sudden, we just lost contact. It really hurt my heart. It was so, so disappointing to me that we had lost contact. And my friend of so many years would never respond to my calls, my texts. It just vanished. And I would pray over the years and say, Lord, what happened? What's going on? But I waited and I trusted God. And years would pass, and I got married and just knew that she would be with me, and she wasn't. But God was doing a new thing in her life and in my life, but I still continued to trust God and wait on his timing. And then on Sunday, the word came, reach out, encourage someone. And I did. The Lord gave me her name to reach out and encourage her and just say, how are you? I'm thinking about you. That resulted in 9 text messages from her, sharing with me emails that we had written to one another over 22 years ago, and she kept them in a binder. Little did I know that she was going through something that herself, but if it wasn't for that act of obedience to reach out, I now have spoken to my friend whom I hadn't spoken to for 10 years. She called last night, and we've been missing one another, but she finally called last night and apologized for where she was. I am so grateful for that one act of obedience on that Sunday, on last Sunday, to say, reach out, encourage someone. I asked my husband, and he reached out and did the same thing, and 3 people called him right back. They were so shocked that he reached out. So it's not too late. Be encouraged. Be encouraging to someone. Just dial the phone, just text a message, encourage someone. You never know what God is doing. You never know how he's going to bless you. You never know how he's going to bless them. 10 years would pass, and he brought us back together. Who knows what the Lord will do? Reach out, encourage someone, and be blessed.
And the angel said to them, fear not. For behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King, let every heart prepare him room, let every
treasure. Sing. Everybody sing.
Glory to the Lord, to the Lord, to the Lord.
Let us receive.
Receive our King.
Every heart, prepare a room.
And heaven and
nature sing. Heaven and nature
sing.
Merry Christmas again. I pray that you have enjoyed this time of ministry, and I want you to focus on the goodness of God. Yes, we're in a difficult season, and it looks like Christmas would not be what it has been in years past. But Jesus is still alive and well, and he's blessing you even at this very moment. So let's think about the positive. Let's keep our minds lifted. Let's make certain, praise God, that we share the joy of this season and introduce Jesus to someone else. He's been there for you. He'll always be there for you. So I praise that you will have a blessed celebration. Give glory and honor to the Father. Lift him up, and Merry Christmas.